Welcome back to the Hog Zone.
Okay, y'all, this one's for Bohemian Hunting Club. All right, James, you're going to really like this. This is how you make a hog rub. Get a piece of carpet. Now, preferably, just grab that throw rug your wife insists on throwing on the wooden floor or tile floor after you put it in. Just pick that sucker up and drag it to the deer lease. What you want to do is pour oil and grease all over this carpet. East Texas, the hogs will rub on pine trees and get that resin, that sap, all in their fur, and then rub in mud and it makes a bunch of layers. Well, down here, they rub on the power lines and get the creosote out of the power poles. I mean, some of the power poles down here, if they're real tarry, have got a 2-foot trench all the way around them.
Okay, y'all, this is one of the power lines that the hogs rub on. And as you can tell, they got it all wallered out down here. And it goes back over to there. But you can see all the mud marks and everything where they rub up and down on there, getting that creosote off.
What we're going to do is make a fake one. We're going to fill this with oil, grease, everything else. And then we're going to wrap it around a tree, nail it to the tree, and then they'll come in and start rubbing on it like they normally would on the power pole or pine tree. Okay, y'all, what I did is I've been cleaning out my father's garage, and he had everything known to man in there. I mean, gear lube. You want thick oil. So just go through your garage. I'm sure everybody's got 50,000 cans of half cans of oil, bearing grease, and everything else in their garage. And just, that's what you want to do. You want to put it on this. You want this thing totally saturated so that it's just full of oil, like an old oily rag that's just been dipped in oil. That's what you want this carpet to look like. Now I'm going to keep putting this on, and we'll move on to something else here in a second. The older and nastier, if you do an oil change or something, you might want to use that oil. Because it smells burnt to them, and you just can't beat it. Now this stuff's running right through, and that's why I put it over a barrel, so that it will. I can just shove it down in the barrel and mix it, you know, and to reabsorb it. Just keep re-dumping it on there until it's totally saturated. Then what I'm going to do is put it in a plastic bag to transport it, and then tomorrow I'm just going to hammer it on the tree, and hopefully we'll have some good results.
Yeah, that carpet's soaking it up. Check this out. It's not even coming through the back. But I got more oil, so we're going to put this stuff on there. Half this crap, I don't even know what it is. I know it's all oil, but here's a good one. We got grease. Good old bearing grease. I guess you could use Vaseline if you don't have any bearing grease just laying around, but like I said, I do mechanic work for a living, so I always got a bunch of fluids, grease, all sorts of crap around the house and the garage. That's about it, guys, and then we're going to stick this to the tree, and it's going to be hog wild on there. It'll be rubbing all over. Found some more crap. This is a lighter grade oil, it's hydraulic oil. But it all worked. Now I'm going to stick it in the plastic bag.
Okay, y'all, this is totally saturated now. So what I'm going to do is wrap it around this tree and nail it down real well. Now I'm bending the nails over so it has a better grip, because these hogs are going to be real rough on this thing. So let me go ahead and nail it up, and then we'll show you what I got after I'm done. Okay, y'all, it's nailed to the tree. I'm probably going to come back and put a bunch more nails in it, because they are going to be extremely rough on it. I'm going to put some nails all through in here, but I ran out of nails. Anyway, it's secure now, but I fully expect in a few weeks all this ground here is going to be a foot deep. It's going to be a trench around it. they'll probably wind up tearing the damn thing off right off the tree. But we'll see what happens. It'll be a nice little experiment. And that's my quick tip, making a hog rub. And, of course, if it does make it through and doesn't come flying off of here, every time you come out, just spray a little more oil on there. And they'll just keep hitting it.